An open source RFID tag for filaments, a wooden Prusa printer, a bigger version of the core one, PrusaSlicer 3.0, and liquid filament for silicone printing, all things I just saw a week ago at Prusa Day 2025. But let's start at the beginning.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning and I'm on my way to Prague to visit Prusa.
Not even 2 weeks ago, a handful of creators and press representatives were invited to Prague, where Prusa Day 2025 was held. And today, I'll show you 5 cool things they revealed there in a really impressive way. When we got there, they didn't take us to the Prusa factory, but the Prague Planetarium, where the presentation was held. This place was just freshly renovated, and the huge dome of the main building is one big screen made from 45 million tiny LEDs for a full 180-degree experience. It was super impressive, to be honest. They didn't tell anyone anything before we arrived. And of course, everyone had their own predictions. I thought, or rather was hoping, that we'd see the coreonel tool changer that both Prusa and Bontech had teased. But I was wrong. First, they talked about the company expansion until they got to the first cool new announcement, the Open Print Tag. It's an RFID tag for filament spools that they hope to establish as an industry standard. It's a writable and reusable ring tag that stores information like filament type, color, and remaining material, and can be used by any 3D printer or filament manufacturer. That's in stark contrast to Bamboo Labs tags, which only come with their own materials and only work on their machines. The Open Print Tag will already be included with every new spool of Prusament, and Prusa also has mentioned that several other manufacturers might adopt them soon. You'll also be able to buy the tags separately from Prusa's store, stick them to your own spools, and flash them yourself with your phone. For them to be truly useful though, we'll need to see support from other printers and firmware like Clipper. But since the whole specification is open source, I think that that'll happen soon. With the introduction of the Open Print Tag, Prusa also updated their Prusament spool design. They removed the cardboard core and made the spool a few millimeters thinner, so it's finally AMS compatible, which I honestly celebrated. Then they shifted to one of Prusa's passion projects. You might have seen the bamboo-housed Core 1 last year at Formnext, which I thought was just a playful jab at Bamboo Lab. But they are actually turning it into a real product. A Czech company will build 250 signature oak machines made from oak wood, which should be available soon. I first wondered if that was the big announcement, but then they transitioned to the main reveal, the Prusa coreonel. Yes, this is Prusa's new large or larger format machine. I would have loved to upload a full review today, but unfortunately the review units are a bit delayed. So if you don't want to miss a deeper look at it very soon, make sure to be subscribed. The coreonel is basically a bigger version of the regular coreonel with a 300x300x320mm print volume, which is by volume twice as big as its smaller sibling, while the external dimensions are only about 10% bigger. The weight stays pretty much the same, thanks to some aluminum side panels instead of steel. The most significant change is that they finally ditched the 24-volt DC bed heater and are now using an AC-powered heater mounted under a thick aluminum plate for optimal heat distribution. They're also using this bed as an active chamber heater by adding two fans underneath to blow air along the bottom of the plate, helping to warm the build chamber to around 60 degrees Celsius, which should be great for technical materials. I'm curious to see if these fans affect the surface temperature uniformity, or if it could even help to cool the bed down faster for easier part removal. The way they showed the changes in the machine was really impressive, because thanks to the planetarium and the 180-degree screen, we were actually placed inside the coreonel, which felt quite a bit like, honey, I shrunk the kids.
That's great!
It's not that great.
Why?
I shrunk the kids.
This seriously was a perspective I've never seen a 3D printer from. They used this to demonstrate some of the nice quality of life improvements, like a top vent that now automatically opens and closes with a lever on the printhead and a switch on the filament sensor that makes loading flexible filaments much easier. How well it prints and whether they were able to fix the VFA issues that plagued the original coreonel is something I'll be able to tell you soon. The coreonel launches today at $1,799 with all tariffs and taxes included, or €1,699 here in Europe. If you want to be one of the first to get it, there's a link in the description that also supports my work over here. Something else that was exciting to see was the first preview of PrusaSlicer 3.0, which will arrive next year. It features a completely new interface and something many will love, project tabs. So you no longer need dozens of separate instances open when working on a complex project. I'm personally thrilled to see this because I've gotten quite used to the clear UIs of Bamboo Studio and Orca Slicer, and I'm happy to see Prusa heading in the same direction too. The last big thing they showed was an update on the Prusa XL, their large tool changer. It won't be overhauled, but they'll finally start introducing new tool heads. The first one will be for silicone printing with their new liquid filament system. I didn't quite get it at first, but they don't pump the two components of the silicone to the head where they mix. Instead, they use thin tubes pre-filled with the material. These liquid filaments are fed to the print head just like regular filament, where they are sliced open and squeezed into a mixing nozzle that deposits the material onto the print bed. This allows you to print all sorts of interesting materials like super soft silicone or even chocolate. And when combined with other print heads on the XL, it opens up possibilities like printing PLA supports for complex silicone parts. I'm really excited to see what will be possible with this. You'll be able to see this and some other new announcements in just a few weeks at Formnext in Frankfurt, where I hope we'll also be able to see the coreonel tool changer in action. So yes, 3D printing really does stay exciting. I hope you enjoyed this short look at some of the new things Prusa is working on. You can find more information about everything in the description below.